That was science fiction, and now we're bringing it into science fact.
This is the next generation of computing. This is the next PC.
It's just unbelievable. It's so trippy to look at.
We've unlocked the screen.
I mean, we are literally smacking up against some of the laws of physics on what we can and can't do with light.
It's basically a see-through display that you wear, and it lets you see holograms in your world, in your space, all around you.
I mean, it's just awesome.
Whoa! Incredible, huh? The possibilities for AR are endless.
Microsoft HoloLens, the world's first and only fully untethered holographic computer.
FS Insider, a premium edition of the Financial Sense NewsHour. Today's host is Senior Editor Chris Sheridan.
So that was Microsoft's new HoloLens, which we are going to discuss today. And if any of you aren't familiar with it, or if you haven't heard about the HoloLens, this is going to be a little bit mind-blowing for you, because it is just such a groundbreaking technology, as someone said in that montage. And today, to speak with us about Microsoft's new HoloLens, is Citizen Inc.'s Director of Emerging Technology, Matt Whitkamp. Matt, thanks for coming on the show and speaking with us today.
My pleasure. Glad to be here.
So Matt, tell us a little bit about what Microsoft HoloLens, what it does, why it is such a groundbreaking technology. I do want to say I tried it on. I went through a tour through Rome. There's a bunch of different things that we're going to get into today that really just astonished me. And I was surprised. I had never heard about this. So I'm guessing that this is going to be new to a lot of people in our audience as well. So would you mind giving our listeners a little bit, just a breakdown on what the HoloLens is and how it differs perhaps from virtual reality or some of the other things that people may be familiar with?
Sure, absolutely. I mean, one of the things that was groundbreaking just for me in my personal experience is the first moment that I put a HoloLens on my head and fired it up, the first thought that came to my head was, okay, science fiction is now reality. You know, because the HoloLens creates this holographic experience where the headset is aware of the world around me. I can see the room around me. It knows where the walls and different surfaces are, and it's able to create an experience where the holograms, or the virtual representations, are able to interact with that world. So it almost feels like these virtual beings or objects are actually part of my physical reality. And, you know, it was, as I started to get used to using the lens, and I, you know, that first day that I was using it, you know, that by the end of the day, it felt eerily familiar. And the reason why I say that is because all of us, we're all three-dimensional beings. You know, there's just something that's just built into our beings and in our brain structures. We know how to interact with a world that is 3D. But if you think about it, as the human race has progressed, you know, we've gotten to this point where we're collecting just unfathomable amounts of data at just rates that are just even hard to comprehend. But the way that we traditionally interact with that data and with that information is through 2D. You know, it started with books. You know, we have these two-dimensional pieces of paper, information's written down, which can be, you know, then reviewed later and then mentally taken in. And of course, technology progresses, and now we're interfacing with our data through two-dimensional screens, you know, through our phones and through our tablets and so forth. Even with three-dimensional representations, you know, that you find in games and other representations, it's still through a two-dimensional screen. And the thing that was really the most impressive to me was just how these things started to feel real. And I started to consider them just differently than I had before when interacting with digital experiences or with even, you know, computers. Because the way that I look at the HoloLens is it's another modality of computing. It's another form of computing. It's another computer.
I think that's one of the big things, is that you're really putting a computer on your head, and it replaces the need, I would say, to even have a computer in the traditional way that we've interacted with computers, with having a monitor or screen in front of you. Now, that's not necessary, because with the HoloLens, I mean, you literally can have as many screens in your visual field as you want. And they're indistinguishable from a real monitor because just the quality of the picture. So I think that right there is just groundbreaking alone. And it makes sense that Microsoft has moved in this direction. But before we go into some of the applications, because there's so many different applications, and you guys are really going to be pretty fascinated with how this can be used and why it's such a powerful use of technology. But tell our listeners a little bit about it, what it looks like, some of the features, just so they can help visualize it. And of course, we are going to have some links to videos and all sorts of different things that you can look at as well. But for those of you that are just listening and perhaps hearing about the Microsoft HoloLens for the first time, help our listeners to picture it a little bit.
Hi, everybody. John Loeffler here. You know, you've just been listening to a free preview of the Financial Sense Insider Premium Edition. Do you need help making sense of the market? I mean, you've heard the old adage, it's a jungle out there. Well, you know, you can join our premium weekday service and you'll gain access to leading experts, analysts, and market technicians on what's driving the markets, the economy, and your future. You can get all of that by subscribing today at financialsense.com. That's Financial Sense, S-E-N-S-E, like you're trying to make sense of something, .com. And click subscribe to join our premium weekday service. You won't regret it.